Welcome to Byte-sized Canvas. I'm Helen Graves, and today I plan to rock your world when it comes to the Canvas Syllabus tool. Whenever I hear an instructor say they don't like the Syllabus tool, or I see they've disabled it in their course navigation, I clap my hands together in gleeful anticipation. Another chance to spout off about one of my favorite design tricks. We all know that syllabi tend to be lengthy, often overwhelming documents. Can you spell mind-numbing? Giving students endless opportunities for, I know I read it somewhere, but now I can't find it, experiences throughout the semester. I'm not here to tell you what should or shouldn't be in your syllabus. We'll leave that hearty debate for another time. Today, I want to show you a method for taming the beast and turning it into something students can actually wrap their brains around. I call it Syllabus Quick Links. It looks like this, and it most definitely gives you a leg up in meeting OEI Course Design Rubric Element A7. I know what you're thinking. Oh my gosh, Helen, this is truly a thing of beauty. How can I get one of those? Well, stick with me, my little friend. I'm going to show you how simple it is. First, you'll create a Canvas page for each section of your syllabus. On that page, you'll copy and paste the text for that section. Once all the pages are created, you simply add the links here on the syllabus page and voila, you have a set of quick links, much like a table of contents for your previously vast and impenetrable syllabus. Let me share a couple of hard-won tips to make the experience easier for both you and your students. First, these pages are what I call orphans, meaning they're not part of a module, so they don't have the previous next buttons at the bottom. The more tech-savvy student won't be fazed by that, but some students will be flummoxed and not sure where to go once they're done reading. The solution is to add a Back to Syllabus link at the bottom of the page. This allows the potentially confused student to return to their original starting point and regain their equilibrium. Second, some sections are really short, so rather than end up with a bazillion links, it's smart to consolidate compatible sections. Here you see I've paired the textbook details with the course objectives. Third, I put the word syllabus at the beginning of the title for all of these pages. That way they're grouped together and easy to find in the pages area. Lastly, to speed up the task of creating the pages, follow these steps. Go to Pages and create a new page. Type Syllabus in the title field. In the Page Edit area, hit Return twice. Type Back to Syllabus, then highlight your text. Using the Insert Content tool, go to Course Navigation and select Syllabus. Now save the page, and you've got a template to use. Create several duplicates of the page. Open them one at a time. Paste in the text. Add the section title. And save and publish the page. Add more duplicates as you need them. See how simple that was? Now for the elephant in the room, the course summary reviled by many an instructor. This is actually a very powerful time management tool for lots of students, providing them with a sequential list of assignments and due dates. It's true they could use the calendar tool to much the same effect, but my accessibility friends have told me the Canvas calendar is less screen reader friendly than the course summary. The objection I frequently hear from instructors about this tool is that some students think the course summary is everything in the course, so not knowing any better, they just click down the list and miss all of your fine learning content in the modules. The way around that hurdle is to add this alert. This quick links method lets you use the Canvas syllabus tool to its best advantage. There may still be the occasional student who jumps right to the assignments, bypassing the content, but they'd probably do that anyway, whether they can access the course summary or not. So why not give the majority of your students the benefit of the tool and the benefit of the doubt? Well, I've blathered on enough for one day. That's it for now. Until next time, this is Helen wishing you a Canvalicious day.